In this video, we'll look at real gases. Most often in chemistry, we'll deal with ideal gases. Ideal gases take a few assumptions from the kinetic molecular theory for gases. The kinetic molecular theory of gases ignores both the volume occupied by molecules of gas and all interactions between molecules, whether attractive or repulsive. Now, these assumptions are not fully correct. In fact, the first one, the fact that molecules do not have any volume, is incorrect. All gases have non-zero molecular volumes. The second, gas molecules have no interactions. Well, gas molecules have attractive and repulsive interactions that increase as we get to high density and slow molecular velocities. If we think about a molecule of gas, it's going to have some volume. Often that volume is going to be relatively small. Often, gases are very, very far away from each other in the volume they contain. So therefore, the assumption that they would have very little interactions is a somewhat correct process if we're dealing with normal pressures and temperatures. What happens with gases as we increase pressure is that the non-ideal behavior of the gas also increases. If we think about pressure increasing, the molecules of the gas are going to have to be forced closer and closer together. This is going to change that idea that they're not going to get close enough to interact. It's also going to have an impact on the non-zero volume that was assumed for the gas. We also see an impact on the non-ideal behavior by a decrease in temperature. As we decrease the temperature, the non-ideal behavior increases. This is directly from the kinetic molecular theory. The more energy we put into a gas by increasing the temperature, the less that those interactions, attractive or repulsive, are going to have an impact on the gas. So therefore, when we go to low temperatures, we see that we're going to have a more non-ideal behavior. So how do we deal with this? Well, van der Waals came up with equation, the van der Waals equation, that takes the normal PV equals nRT and puts in a couple of correction terms. The first term, P plus a constant A times the square of the number of moles divided by the volume squared, multiplied by the second term, volume minus the number of moles and a constant B equals nRT. We can see from this that the two terms that we need to focus on are A n squared over volume squared and NB. If we look at these two terms, they have a specific correction. The A, which is a constant that you look up for every specific gas, is part of the correction for molecular interactions. The NB, and B is also a constant that you have to look up for every separate type of gas, is the correction for the volume of the molecules, the fact that all gas molecules have a non-zero molecular volume. When is it important to use these two terms? Well, it's important when we get to very high pressures or very low volumes, or combinations of both of those. If we're dealing with our normal STP values, standard temperature and pressure, where temperature is 0 degrees Celsius or 273.15 degrees Kelvin, and pressure 1 atmosphere, the ideal glass law is pretty close. We do need to consider van der Waals equation whenever we're dealing with incredibly high pressures or very low temperatures. Accuracy is going to be essential to the process.